Anyway, oh, round this rock. Oh, I think, have we actually arrived at Sionwood? I think so, but first, let's just have this quick battle against this Tentacool. You're gonna use Toxic Spikes, that's not gonna be a problem, because I'm just gonna carry on using Pidgeotto. And more Toxic Spikes, okay, you really want to try and harm, like, a Pokemon that I might want to switch out to. But I got some bad news for you, Tentacool. Not only am I not planning on, switching out my Pokemon, but I'm going to knock you out with Last Quick Attack. So, you're lost there, Tentacool. Anyway, yeah, we've made it! We've made it to Sionwood! Sionwood, Sionwood, whatever you want to call it, I'm going to still call it Sionwood. It's my Let's Play. I think I'm free to mispronounce things. Anyway, let's just heal our Pokemon. Although I'm going to quickly head back out to sea because we went pretty much the long way around. So there's probably a few more battles that we could do. Gym leader uses fighting type. Is into his waterfall training. He won't be able to hear you unless you somehow stop the pounding water. Okay. Right. Have you met the maniac in this city? Right, okay. Do I want to talk to a maniac? Right. Well, we're in the city, but I'm just gonna very quickly head back out to sea. And just see if there's any other trainers that I can battle against. There probably isn't too many thinking about it, but you know what, it wouldn't hurt to have a quick look around. Ooh, a Tentacruel! But you're only level 15. I think Pidgeotto could still take care of this Tentacruel. And again with the Toxic Spikes! Okay, well, whatever. You can do Toxic Spikes if you want. It's not gonna do you any good. Oh, I thought you were gonna actually get somewhere there, but nope. As it turns out, it wasn't enough. Alright, let's have another look around. Have I battled you? No, I haven't. Okay, we are in a different bit here. Yes, I see it. Well, you don't say. Anyway, so now we're challenging Burke, who sends out a Quillfish. Alright. Let's use Gus because I'm not sure if you're... I don't know if you have an ability that will poison me if I make physical contact with you, so let's just keep our distance. Ah, Toxic Spikes. Well, looks like you're just going to have to deal with it, Pidgeotto. And again with the Toxic Spikes, fine. I'll just carry on using Gust. And one more for good luck. Oh, minimize again. Evasive Rose, but I still managed to get you. And yep, you're gone. And thankfully, that was the only Pokemon you had. What's the secret to my strength? Just using Gust and not switching out my Pokemon because you decided to use the Toxic Spike strategy there. Which, sadly for you, my friend, did not work. Anyway, let's just take care of this wild Tentacool. Yeah, that didn't do much damage. Let's just finish off with Gust. Oh, I actually did not knock you out. Actually, you know what? It's been a while since I've caught a new Pokeball, so... You know what, Tentacool? I think I will try and catch you. I've got two more Pokeballs, might as well get rid of them because I'm probably not going to be using the original Pokeballs anymore. Ooh, yeah, she managed to break out. Cheeky. Well, I was thinking about switching out to another Pokeball, but not anymore. So you know what? Let's just use Gust. If it knocks you out, so be it. Yep. Screw it. I don't really care for Tentacool. Hello, let's battle. At night, star you gather near the water's surface. There we go. Who needs a Pokedex when you got other people to tell you Pokeball facts? So you tell me about Staryu, yet you send out a Horsea. Alright, fine by me. We'll take care of this Horsea. Also, yeah, definitely worth thinking about it, training up my Pidgeotto, considering we are going to be taking on the next gym who is a specialist in fighting type. Thinking about it, I may... maybe I should have caught like that Drowsy near Goldenrod. Because having a psychic type would be useful. Although, if Eevee would hurry up and actually evolve into an Espeon, that would be most good. Although, thinking about it, you probably won't know any psychic moves for a little while anyway. But you know what? I still want my Espeon, dammit. Alright, Eevee, I'll let you take care of this battle now. Give Pidgeotto a little break. Oh no, my defense fell. Whatever am I going to do? I know. I'm going to use another quick attack and knock out this Horsea. See, you tell me about Staryu, yet both of your Pokemon were Horsea. Okay, whatever. Right, let's train Eevee up again. And have a little swim around here. Ah, yes, still one more person. I'm a bit tired. If I win, lend me your Pokemon. That's not how it works. Because then I'll be stuck at sea. Whoa, 6 Pokemon? Okay, right. Someone who actually has a full squad for a change. They're probably going to be fairly low leveled, but... bring it on. Remoraid? I think this is the first time I've seen Remoraid. Nice to see someone actually have a full squad of Pokemon for a change. Even though I am like one-shotting all these Pokemon, but... you know, it's good for me. Also, already you get a variety of Pokemon here. Camouflage didn't work for you. Do I dare use Tackle? Yes. Okay, I did not regret it for once. And Eevee is going to level up once again. Level 26. Another Tentacool. Okay, looks like he has multiple Pokemon at some occasions. But you know what? At least it's not like that one person that we battled against who had a whole bunch of Magikarp. Ugh, that was a pain. another Tentacool. Ah, okay, I'm guessing half your squad is Tentacool. That's not very exciting, but again, compared to someone who just had Magikarp, at least you have Pokemon that can, at the very least, somewhat attack. So, I hate to say it to you, George, but you're going to lose this battle quite badly. Very badly indeed. And actually, thanks to that battle, Eevee almost leveled up again. Not too bad. But still not enough to evolve. Looks like Eevee's still not quite at its happiest yet. Oh, Psy, Duck. Can't really do my impressions right now. Right, just use Quick Attack. Actually, I haven't actually bothered to check my inventory in a while. I'm just wondering if I have a certain item that might help Eevee be a little bit more happier. But let's just do this battle first. And have a look. Ooh. One more quick attack will do the job. And hopefully you'll give me a decent amount of experience points. Oh, you do. Oh, you do. Thank you, Goldie. Nice. Sorry, Susie. Oh, now I'm getting a call from Ian. Who is Ian again? Okay, who was Ian again? I can't remember where we were, but... Oh, it must have been near Goldenrod. I guess that makes sense considering you were talking about Drowsy. Well, there we go. There's probably a few other Pokemon trainers along here that I may have missed, but you know what? We might as well head back to Cyanwood and... check out the place. And seeing as we got this wild tentacle, I might as well battle it. There we go, just to give you a few more experience points there, Eevee. Oh, this is going to be slow going. I mean, I could just use some repels. Level 10? Oh, forget that. No, not worth it. Let's just get out of here. Not worth it. It's level 10. Let's just attempt to get back to Cyanwood and explore it proper. Level 17? No, you know what? I think we've done enough battling for now. We need to check out the city. And also, see if we can find... Oh, come on, really? Right by the shore? What Pokemon is it? Of course it's a tentacle. Ooh, level 23 though. Alright, I'll battle a level 23 tentacle. But only because you were so rude to interrupt me whilst travelling on the water. I was just about to arrive on the shore and you had to come along, didn't you, tentacle? So you know what? I was thinking about using Tackle on you, but no. Quick attack on you. Yeah. Just think about what you're gonna do next time, Tentacle. Also, a camera? Yeah, sure, why not? Let's take a picture. I know what all of my Pokemon are in, but we'll just have to make do with what we have here. That's not too bad. Anyway. We'll probably take a better picture at some point. But, let's just heal our Pokemon once again. And have a little look around the place. There we go, Eevee goes back into its Pokeball. Heal up and see what this gym is all about. Well, of course, we already know what it's about. It's a fighting type gym, so definitely worth training up Pidgeotto. But I kind of want to do some general training anyway. Eevee, what are you holding? I think you're holding... Yeah, you're holding the silk scarf. Do I have a specific item? I don't think I do. Wait, yes I do! The Soothe Bell, that's what I was thinking. Right, the silk scarf makes your normal type move stronger, but I'm going to give you the Soothe Bell. I don't know why I didn't give you that sooner. Hopefully that will make you evolve sooner if you're going to be more happier. Ah, Cyanwood City Pharmacy. 500 years of tradition. We await your medical queries. Ah, mythical sea creature supposedly lives there. Oh, I'd love to check it out, but we won't be able to do that for a little while. Huh? You need medicine? Your Pokemon appears to be fine. Is something worrying you? The Lighthouse Pokemon is in trouble? I got it. This ought to do the trick. Nice, we got the secret potion. I only offer it in an emergency. Okay. Wow. And you just carry on watching TV. But do we need any more medicine? I think we might be alright for now, so I tell you what. We're okay for now. Well, come back anytime. Sure, if you carry on watching TV. Wow. Great customer service there. You're supposed to be running a shop, yet you spend pretty much all your time just watching TV. Fair enough. Anyway, let's have a little talk to these people. I'm in shock. A guy about your age with piercing eyes and long hair came in. He scared me into giving me my prized Pokemon. I still have one left. But what if he comes back? You look after my Pokemon. Yeah, although I don't have any space. Although, I think I vaguely remember what it is, so... we'll see. Anyway, a port of crashing waves. Oh, there we go. And... what have we got? You crossed the sea to get here. That must have been hard. Ah, okay, so presumably... you will have the HM for Fly. Oh yeah. He's so into his training, he doesn't seem to notice you. Well, that's just rude. Well, you know what? I'm not quite ready to take on the gym just yet. I've still got some buildings to check out. I'm still exploring. And yes, as a Pokemon trainer, I am freely allowed to barge into anyone's house. I heard that you can only see it if you have the silver wing. Ah. Yeah. Yeah, someone else pretty much said that as well. You might need a special move to get past them. Yes, that is indeed true. But, again, that won't happen for a while or so. Ah, so that explains the camera. This is Cameron's house. It'll be a good memory. Well, I've already taken a picture. So, no need to worry. Use Fly and get back to Olivine instantly. Well, that's the plan. Boulders to the north of town can be crushed. They may be hiding something. Your Pokemon could use Rock Smash to break them. Oh! Suicune! Haha! Hang on, I'll interact with you in a moment. I've just got to quickly walk into this house and pretend I'm not shocked. I remember last time someone came to visit me. When I was young, I was a Pokemon trainer too. I tried to reach the tower and dive into the ocean. Put a lot of effort into main figs. Well, I take things easy now, listening to waves and winds on the beach. Fair enough. So you're just there for a talk. And yeah, there's Suicune. And off it goes. Haha, oh, you missed it, didn't you, Eucene? Alright, first battle against this this guy now. Alright, so he sends out a Drowsy, but I'm probably going to switch Pokemon. You know what? Quilava hasn't had a battle in a while. Let's bring out Quilava. Ooh, he tried to use Hypnosis. Cheeky. I'm not having that, Drowsy. Except he still used Hypnosis. Use the cheap tactics. Well, I would use Awakening, but you'll probably just end up using Hypnosis by some random miracle. Come on, Quilava. Ah, Dream Eater. You know Dream Eater. Right, come on, Quilava, wake up, please, wake up. Come on, Quilava. Well, I think I'm gonna have to use a super potion because Quilava is too busy being asleep. That'll do for now, but I might have to switch you out. Come on, wake up! Oh, come on, Quilava! Why aren't you waking up? Oh, the game's being very mean to me now. It's decided that it wants me to take the longest amount of time to wake up. So you know what? Screw you, Drowsy. Ha ha ha! I'm awake, you fool. And now you're gonna suffer the consequences of your actions. Yeah, you do that to my Quilava, that's what you get. But seriously, Quilava, why did you take forever to wake up? I know you haven't been battling in a while. Ooh, Swift. Alright, I'll let you learn Swift. Do I? What's the power on that? 60, but of course it never misses. You know what? We don't need Quick Attack. Replace it with Swift. That would be good in an emergency. Electrode. Let's switch for now. Let's bring out Eevee once again. See what level this Electrode is. Ooh, level 27. Right, okay. Quite strong. Alright, Dratini it is then. Alright, I'm not gonna lie, Eucene is pretty strong. You know Thunder? I'm not having that. Ah, Dratini's Quick Claw came into effect there. Let's use Dragon Rage. Get a guaranteed 40 hit points of damage. Let's see how much health you actually have. Oh, you're trying to use Thunder, are you? Oh, yeah, bravo. You actually managed to get Dratini in the end, even though it didn't do a huge amount of damage. So let me just use Dragon Rage once again, because I like Dragon Rage, and yep, that's knocked out your Electrode. Go. And next you're going to send out Haunter. Switch Pokemon. I mean, we'll switch to Eevee. Actually, how close are you to leveling up? 576 points. Alright, might as well shift you out anyway. And we'll just bring out Ampharos, because Quilava's just a little bit on the weak side. Again, trying to use the Hypnosis technique. Well, you know what? I'm not having that. Ew, getting a ghostly lick, and I get paralyzed for it. But luckily, Ampharos can still attack. Nice, not too bad. A simple Thunder Shock should be enough. Ew, another ghostly lick. Oh, and of course I'm paralyzed. Yeah, sometimes I think the game goes against me sometimes. Although, haha, now you're paralyzed. There we go, finish off this battle. And Frost can restore a little hit points, but we'll be heading back to the Pokeball Center. Hate to admit it, but you win. Wow, that's a lot of money. Neat. I'm starting to understand why Suicune was keeping an eye on you. I'm going to keep searching. Yeah, we probably will. Well, until next time. Admittedly, you are pretty strong. Anyway, we've got some rocks we could smash here. Also, there's a cave here. Entrance to the road for the Safari Zone. So we can get to the Safari Zone from here. But I don't think we can actually go any further right now, because I think we need to wait for a phone call to let us know that the Safari Zone will be open. Anyway, let's just quickly heal our Pokemon. There we go. Alright, so Pokemon healed. I suppose we might as well check out the gym. But before that, I don't have it. For some reason, I thought I already had the strength HM, but apparently I don't. Huh. I guess I missed it somewhere, or have I not got it yet? I swear I picked up strength somewhere. Hang on a second. Okay, so just a quick check, and yeah, we don't get strength until we get to another route, which is back on the mainland, but hopefully I won't need it, at least I hope I don't. Anyway, so you know what, we might as well check out the gym now, why not? And see what's what. Well, that's it for this episode of my Pokemon Soul Silver Let's Play, but there'll be some more coming up very soon. So for the time being, thanks very much for watching. Be sure to leave a like and subscribe if you enjoyed this video. And until next time, I shall catch you all later.